time to talk about recursion. Let's get into it. As you may know already, Blake Crouch is the author of Dark Matter, which I have not read, but I always heard great things about, so hopefully one day I'll get around to it. But when this book came from the offerings from Random House, who did send me my review copy for free, I had to say yes. To give you a brief description of the story, essentially there is a cop and a scientist, and we have dual perspectives going forward through this timeline. Out of nowhere, this strange disease seems to be on the rise, and they're calling it false memory syndrome, but no one really understands what is going on, or what it is, or what causes it. All they know is that some people are reporting suddenly waking up and then remembering vast memories about other lives than the ones they're living in. These memories are so real to them that they are convinced that it really happened. They feel confused. They don't know which is true, which world they're supposed to belong in. There's a rash of suicides as a result, as people's psyches are just more and more confused by what's going on. Everyone's saying that it's some sort of strange syndrome, right? But it turns out that the answer is a hell of a lot more complicated than that. This is a thriller, and as usual, I don't want to say too much because I don't want to ruin this for you if you decide to read it. I truly believe that thrillers should just be discovered by the reader. What I can speak to, though, is the writing style, the voices, and the overall pacing of this book. First off, we have to acknowledge how incredible and vast and just all-encompassing this concept for this book is. It is so complicated, so complex, that it is extremely difficult to pull off, and yet the author did so. That in itself is a testament to great writing and should be praised and bowed down to, because it is so intricate, everything that happens. It's kind of like people are calling it just a mind puzzle, or like your mind's blown by the end of it. And that's true. So I want to give the author his due when I'm talking about the plot of this book, because to even have the idea for that, but then to figure out a way to execute it in a way that makes sense, in a way that is efficient and stylistically engaging, but without being overbearing, I mean, 10,000 points to Ravenclaw, I guess, or whatever respective Hogwarts house he is in. For that reason, a lot of people seem to be absolutely loving this book, and there's a lot of 4- and 5-star reviews out there. It's a little hard for me to settle on a number review. This one, I think, is going to be about a 4-star, but it's definitely on the edge of being more of a 3.5-star for me. There's mostly 2 reasons why that is. I didn't have any problems with the overall writing style or the pacing, but I just had a few problems with the characters and feeling like they were real and being convinced of their storylines and therefore being emotionally impacted by what happens to them. There's also a love element that didn't quite convince me. And whenever there is love, I would really like to be fully convinced of it, especially because this book is so grand in scope. It's really impressive, and I wanted to have the character dynamic be as strong as the plot was. And I know that's asking a lot, but hey, I'm still gonna want what I want, and I am not dissing the plot at all, but I just wanted a bit more development there, or a bit more feeling behind the characters that they felt corporeal to me. On the other end of the spectrum, I did not have a problem with pacing. This book was actually really easy to get to, which is great in my opinion for a thriller. That's a key piece of what a thriller should be. However, due to the nature of this book and because of the intricacies, it's impossible for it not to become repetitive. And that's really challenging for a writer to handle well without tiring the audience. Near the end, I was very close to being on the edge of just over the repetitive nature. But it's part of the story, it's inherent, and you can't have the story without that repetitive nature. So if that's gonna irk you, that's something to know going in. Some people don't really care about that stuff, some people do, so I just wanted to give you a heads up that that was definitely a thought that I had. It has to be in there, but it still kind of feels like a lot. And that feeling of a lot is pretty much why I decided to rate this around 4 stars, because sometimes it just felt too much, a little too cheesy, or just a little too far at the edge of believability. But the concept is fantastic, the pacing is pretty standard, pretty good for a thriller, and if you want to have your mind bended a little bit, then this is definitely a great summer read for you. A lot of people are loving it. You might not find any issue at all with the things I had issue with, so I definitely still recommend it. But that is it for my quick review of Recursion. I hope that if you choose to read it, you enjoy it a heck of a lot, and I hope that if you have read it, you will drop me a comment below so that we can discuss it. Please, before you hop off this video, give it a quick thumbs up, drop me a comment below, and if you're new here and you haven't subscribed yet, but you like all things bookish, book reviews, TBRs, unhauls, all the good bookish stuff, then I'm your girl. So go ahead, press that subscribe button, and I will see you on the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys.